years. After 1000 years, we get desired characters. Desired characteristic. This is called selective breeding. So, in this method, two plant or animal with specific characteristics are selected to produce offspring. Do you know what is selective breeding? I am telling you, but how it will be done? Now tell you. So, in this method, that means in method of selective breeding, two plant or animal, either two plants are selected or two animals are selected to give their offspring. Then what happens after this? For example, wild sheep have two types of hair on their bodies. I tell you example, wild sheep, not normal sheep. Wild sheep have two types of hair on their bodies. That will be coarse, longer hair and soft, shorter hair. Sheep have two types of hair, long, shorter hair. That means two types of hair, coarse, longer hair and soft, shorter hair. Then what happened? Near the skin, selective breeding is done to get sheep with a long, soft hair. That means long, soft hair is good quality of hair, so it will be desired to obtain from the sheep. What happened? In India, sheep are reared in the state of Andhra Pradesh. I am telling you where sheep are reared. Sheep are reared in India, in the state of Andhra Pradesh, Bihar, Gujarat, Jammu and Kashmir, Karnataka, Maharashtra, Rajasthan, Tamil Nadu and Uttaranchal. The bulk of the wool that produced in India is a coarse and is used to manufacture hand-knitted carpet. That means a bulk of the wool, maximum wool, is a that produce of India in the coarse form. That wool is found in the coarse form and used to manufacture a hand-knitted carpet. From that wool, hand-knitted carpet will be made. Then several varieties of sheep are reared in India. Many varieties of sheep are reared in India. But now I am telling you production of wool. Then what will be production of wool? What about production of wool? I am telling that before. This is the steps of production of wool. What the step? Shearing, scoring, grading, carding, spinning, dyeing and knitting are the steps of production of wool. So first of all, I am telling you about shearing. So when the sheep has grown a thick coat of hair, when a sheep is grown thick coat of hair, then hair is removed. So the removal of fleece or hair from the sheep body is called shearing. Removal of hair from the sheep body is called shearing. This can be done by the hand using large razors or clippers or using machine. That means shearing process is done with the help of razors or with the help of machines. This process should be carried out without hurting sheep. That means in this process, animals is not hurted. Animals, that means sheep is not hurted. Shearing is normally done twice a year. That means shearing is done in a year two times. But in some areas, it is done thrice a year. In some areas, shearing is done in thrice a year, three times in a year. After that, I am telling you scoring. So about scoring, the process of washing the sheared fleece, the process of washing the sheared sheep fleece with the soap and water to remove dust, dirt and grease. The process of washing the sheared wool to remove dirt, dust and grease is called scoring. After that, I am telling you grading. So separating the fleece based on the quality of fibers. Separating the fleece based on the quality of fibers, it is called grading. We convert different grades of wools. So the wool from the shoulder and the sides of the sheep are the best quality. What wool are the best quality? The wool from the shoulder and sides of the sheep. Shoulder of the sheep, that means wool obtained from the shoulder of the sheep and wool obtained from the side of the sheep are the best quality. Then The wool from the hind legs of the sheep used to make carpet. That means wool from the hind legs of the sheep used to make carpet, and the soft fluffy fibers called burrs are removed. That means soft fluffy fibers which are called burrs that are removed in the process of grading. After that, carding. The washed and graded wool which is straightened and passed through a machine. Washed wool and graded wool then put into the machine. The machine lays the fiber parallel to each other. The machine convert these wool into fibers which are parallel to each other. They can be easily spun into yarn. That means this process fibers are converted into yarn. Then what happen? Residual dirt and other matter sticking to the fiber are also removed under this stage. That means residual dirt and other matter are also removed in the process of carding. Then I am telling you about the spinning. So the clean fiber are spun into long thread called yarn. The clean fibers are spun into long thread called yarn. That in the process of spinning yarn will be formed. Then this can be done hand or by using machine. That means spinning is done by hand or using machine. After that, I am telling you the time, which the step of production of wool. The process of adding color to the fibers. The process of adding color to the fibers, yarns and fabric is called dyeing. That means in this process, fabric obtain color, different colors. The fiber are dyed in the desired color. Since the wool can be dyed easily, wool can be colored easily, very easily. This process is done about any stage. At any stage, it can be done. The coloring and dyeing of the fabrics will be done. So lastly, I am telling you knitting. Then what about knitting? So one of the preferred method to make woolen yarn into cloth is knitting. One of the preferred method to make woolen yarn into cloth is called knitting. So this is done by knitting loops of woolen yarn using knitting needles or using knitting machine. Knitting will be done or using a hand operated needle or using machine. So I think that all these understood very well. If not understood, you contact on my WhatsApp number and I will confirm. So this much enough. Thanks.